I am speaking to you from the cabinet room at 10 Downing Street. This morning, the British ambassador in Berlin handed the German government a final note stating that unless we heard from them by 11 o'clock, that they were prepared at once to withdraw their troops from Poland, a state of war would exist between us. I have to tell you now that no such undertaking has been received, and that consequently this country is at war with Germany.
On May the 18th, we will be celebrating the life and accomplishments of one man.
A man who made a difference.
Without this man, 669 children wouldn't have had their chance of freedom.
We are here to celebrate Sir Nicholas Winton.
In the autumn of 1938, Europeans were led to believe that Adolf Hitler had been pacified by handing him a large chunk of Czechoslovakia. The infamous Kristallnacht of November 9th, 1938, laid to rest any doubts about Hitler's deadly intentions.
During this time, Nazi thugs destroyed Jewish synagogues, homes, and businesses, whilst murdering many Jews across Germany. When we spoke to Michael Zantowski, the Czech Republic ambassador, he shared his thoughts about the hero that is Sir Nicholas Winton.
He was a stockbroker, I understand, and he was planning a skiing trip to Switzerland in 1939. And a friend told him about the situation in Czechoslovakia at the time and about the danger these children lived under. And he simply decided to do something about it. He did it, and then he apparently forgot about it. And it was only when his wife, 34 years later, was clearing the attic of the house, she came across some boxes with documents about what he did and about the children, and that's how the story came up.
He organized a total of 8 trains from Prague to London. He also helped to find foster families for the refugees.
He inspires us because he helped others during hard times.
He inspires us because he gave freedom to those whose freedom was taken away.
He inspires us because he never gave up on his quest to help as many children as possible.
There are a number of schools who make it a job to spread and retell the story of Nicholas Winton. It speaks to the humility and genuine decency of the man. There are people who will do things to get recognized, to satisfy their own ego. And they, you know, they do make a contribution in doing so, but he's different. He is an inspiration to us all.
I know that you will all play your part with calmness and courage.